Yeah, first of all, also good morning from me here for the audience in this room, but also to the audience which are watching this event on live stream. Before I start, I would like to give a thank you. Thank you to Bjorn, thank you also to Kevin and the whole team from Milestone to give me the opportunity today here on the stage to present the Open Security and Safety Alliance. I brought something with me today, which I want to show you. Maybe the ones in the middle can't see that good, but this is a glass. It's a glass full of sand. So let's imagine for a moment the amount of sand we see here in this glass is reflecting the amount of data we as an industry are currently accessing and we as an industry are currently using to build our solutions. But let's also imagine how much data is out there, because we talk about IP cameras, we talk about a very data-rich sensor we can tap into. And when you think about what kind of data would be available for us out there, I think it looks something like that. So let's imagine you would have access to all the sand we see at that beach and to all the data we have in this industry. Let's make one more comparison. Based on the amount of sand I have here in my glass, we are able to build solutions which basically bring a value add to our customers and end users. So how does these solutions look like? I think they look a little bit like that. It's a nice sand castle. It's well defined. But if we go back to the beach, if we go back to all the data we have seen at the beach, wouldn't it be great if we together could build something that looks like this? So having said that, let's have a quick look at the market we are currently acting in. There are certain assets in this market, and I mentioned earlier, number of IoT devices are growing year over year. And looking at IP cameras only, we have 100 million or even more cameras which are added to this market every single year. And this leads to a skyrocketing amount of data. Wouldn't that be great if we can use all of this data for our solutions? But we also need to consider that there is just a limited use of data. So we just talk about the amount of sand you've seen in the glass. And last but not least, the fragmentation we've also heard throughout today and yesterday's presentation is leading to a lot of friction in our industry. So this makes us think about certain topics. The first one is, when you talk about data, large amounts of data, you talk about sensitive data, you talk about private data. So trust is one of the key essential topics we as an industry need to take care of. We need to make data security a priority. We need to make privacy protection a priority. But it also makes us think about mechanisms. How do we unlock this trapped value? How do we get access to this beach? At the same time, not one solution fits all, so therefore also customization is an important factor to consider. And last but not least, let's find a way to make it easy for us, to make it easy and frictionless to be able to deploy solutions out there which really bring a value add to this industry. And this is the point where the idea was born about the Open Security and Safety Alliance. So I brought with me today the purpose. Let me read it out to you, because we spent a lot of time on this great sentence. So the purpose of the alliance is the creation of an ecosystem to define common market approach to open up new market opportunities by driving the creation and promotion of a framework and common hardware and software platform. That sounds great, right? But how did we get there? How did we get there? So it basically all started with a small team in the middle of 2017, and I was part of that team where we came up with the idea, and we thought we need to change something here in this industry. We need to take a different approach. So we went out there and tried to find some like-minded companies and organizations which are supporting this idea. So a lot of travel was done, a lot of discussions were done, and at the end of the day, we were very happy to find five like-minded companies which were basically willing to be bold a little bit, to change the way of working, and which also would like to create some platform business in this industry. So we had our five founding members, which were Milestone, Pelco, Vivotech, Hanwha, and Bosch. And at that point in time, we had our first board meeting of the Alliance on the 13th of July, 2018. And this is where all of this started with the official launch at last year's GSX in Las Vegas. So what is this Alliance about? It was for us pretty clear from the beginning. We talk about platform business here, and platform business always is a pull market. So we need to put users and customers in the middle. Because at the end of the day, they define the needs in this industry, and we also need to make sure that whatever we do, this is something they can work with, and this is something that pleases their needs. But to be able to do so, it's important to have the whole value chain also represented in this alliance. So this goes from the SoC providers to the device manufacturers, system integrators, VMS players, but also integrators, you name it. And this was also one of the reasons why, after we launched the alliance, we are quite happy that within the first 6 months, we already were able to basically have 20 members on board in 6 months. And you see, these companies are from all areas of the industry. But we are also aware that we are just at the beginning here. So defining common solutions takes companies which are active, which want to go into this direction. So also, we can basically imagine having much more people on board here. So if you feel emphasized by this, if you feel the need to be able to change something and work together with us, there is still room for you as well. Talking about work, so what did we do in the first 6 months? We basically established three committees: the technical committee, the marketing committee, and the strategy committee. And we basically said to ourselves, the most important thing to work on is to find a way how do we address common challenges in this industry to enable innovation and also to unlock this trapped value. And there are two elements which are crucial from our point of view. One is a common technology stack for the IP cameras. And the second one is a specification, so we have one common vendor-agnostic operating system which can run on these IP cameras. Let me give you some details. What you see here is the current market approach, where we have an SoC which is optimized for the industry. We have some vendor-specific operating system on top of that, which has proprietary APIs, where app developers can basically develop apps for this specific camera or for this specific type of camera. What we have in mind as an alliance is something that looks a little bit like this, where we still have an SoC which is optimized for this industry, but this SoC also goes beyond. For example, with built-in acceleration for artificial intelligence and neural networks. Then we believe we need a vendor-agnostic OS which takes care of all the common challenges we have in this industry, being it data security, being it mechanisms to update, mechanisms to deploy security patches, and so on and so forth. But at the same time, and this is a very important point, still leave room for the vendors to differentiate and bring out their specific solutions to this industry. And if we combine this with some standardized API, all of a sudden, we are interested as an industry for app developers which can develop apps which are device agnostic. So let's imagine you're an app developer and you want to develop something, and all of a sudden you have millions and millions of cameras available out there. Isn't this a great way to scale your business? So we believe with this technology stack, it's a first step in bringing innovation and new blood into this industry. But again, and I'm repeating myself here, but it's an important topic, this can only work if we ensure a high level of trust with a common approach for cybersecurity and also privacy protection. And also mentioned earlier, we talk about a platform business here, so the reduction of friction is a must. It has to be easy to deploy solutions, and it has to be easy that people develop and bring innovation into this industry. So now you might ask yourself, what is in it for me? On the one side, you can be part of the next wave within this industry. And we have heard it yesterday in Kevin's presentation. This is security 5.0 at its best. So if we find here a common approach to common market challenges, and if we find a way that we have a common approach for everything that's basically below the line that everybody in this industry has to do anyhow to be successful, you can focus your R&D resources and your capacities on something that makes it different to the customer, that differentiates your solution moving forward. And I mentioned earlier as well, with this approach, it's easier to scale business, and it's also easier for app developers and software companies to basically approach this market and bring innovation and solution based on all this data we have available and can untrap with this approach. So in a nutshell, OSSA, the main aim for us is that we move this industry from a pipeline business to the world towards of platforms. It's not an easy approach. It's something where you have to put some different way of thinking into place, where you also have to be bold sometimes. But let's imagine with all of this activity, if we use this common approach, what kind of nice sandcastles we could build together. Thank you very much for your attention. One more thing before I leave the stage. I'm also quite happy that one of our very active OSSA partners is here with me today. It's a company that is one of the reasons why this alliance is moving so fast. And it's also a company that basically takes what the alliance is defining and specifying and put it into real-life activities and products. Please welcome Nico from SAST.
Thank you. Thank you, Daniel. Good morning. Wow. Let me take you guys back to something we did end of last year. I think it was October, November timeframe. We actually ran a little hackathon, and maybe here and there different to what you all would expect right now. We invited developers from outside the industry. It was for Android developers who knew Android and smartphones very well. And it was for computer vision developers, developing computer vision for industrial manufacturing, drones, autonomous driving. And we matched them up, so we kind of played Tinder for developers. So one Android person, one computer vision person, we teamed them and we gave them a challenge. We showed them a small museum environment with a Mona Lisa poster and some other things. And we proposed forward challenges and user needs that we understood at that time from museums. We talked to security guards there, we talked to museum directors, we talked to visitors, and we put then these developers to work. And for us, just to manage expectations, we had the 2 days. So for us, it was important to take all the learnings with us. Yeah? So we were curious, what do developers from outside the industry think about this? They've never seen or touched a video security camera as a developer device. So we were curious to see what kind of concepts and architectural ideas they would come up with. Before I can tell you what the outcome was, let me back up and go back a little bit. So we heard a lot about platforms, and I don't want to repeat all the details here, that's not the idea. But also we from SAST, when we started out, we obviously also looked at other platform businesses. And for me, these examples, just to pick a few, are really impressive. You have Uber, and I looked it up yesterday, since it wasn't clear from yesterday. They started in mid-2010 in San Francisco, actually. And in the meantime, they have nearly 60% of market share capturing in the US for paid ground transportation, 60%. The other numbers are certainly as equally impressive, Amazon having 9 times of her growth rate compared to traditional retailers. Think about the app stores of the smartphones you use. That's a market penetration and capturing within the first 4 years of $44 billion. There was somewhere else before, it didn't exist before. Again, from a number perspective, tremendously impressive. At the same time, think about all the innovation and the user centricity and ease of use these platforms also brought. Not sure how your taxi ride was from the Copenhagen airport to here. Mine was funny, yeah? So I overheard a private conversation from the taxi driver. There was a lot of food eating at the same time. And at the end, when I paid with a credit card, I got this nice Danish, ah. And when he realized, hey, now I have to pay with chip as well, booting up a device. So it wasn't unpleasant. Let me not complain completely. But it wasn't an Uber experience, right? So you certainly miss out there. And we thought, how would you bring this innovation power to the security market as well? How do you do that? And we set out and launched a company of security and safety things, also in September 2018, just a little bit less than half a year ago. We're quite a growing team. We're close to 100 people in the meantime, mainly in Munich. And we're also a very proud member of the Open Security and Safety Alliance, as Daniel shared. How do you do this then? And to explain this, let me back up and actually also start again from the ecosystem and the industry that Daniel was explaining already earlier. You have, of course, users. You have developers in this industry today. You have integrators. You have video management system manufacturers. You have camera manufacturers. And they all try to grasp something there. They all try to drive for solutions. I think the intention is right of this industry. The intention is at the right place. What we are setting out to do is basically making it possible that all these players can connect on one platform, that they can connect on one platform and drive this innovation forward together. And looking at all these players and these ideas that are out there, coming from Daniel's analogy, we realized we had to bring better sand shovels. We had to bring better tools in this industry in order to capture this and make it easier to build something better and greater. The way you do this is one approach, looking first of all at video security cameras in this market. We are setting out to bring one common operating system based on Android into this industry for multiple manufacturers. And the nice idea is also, if you look at your smartphones on your table, so that you have in your hands right now to solve the crisis at home, not sure. If you look at those smartphones, you have something like 8 CPUs and 4 GPUs in there. 8 CPUs and 4 GPUs. That's quite some compute power, right? And I'm not talking even about, let's say, the latest model, so that's fairly standard right now. But just imagine you bring this power also to our industry, the ability you could build on that. Then you go further and bring one common software development environment to that. And that played out nicely when you go out to developers also outside the industry and they see something familiar. They see something that they've seen at other platforms that accelerates things quite tremendously. If you're inside the industry already, it also helps you to capture whatever innovation value you're already driven, whatever solutions you already have, and bring it then actually also inside this platform. Last but not least, so now when you have these applications developed, you still want to market them, right? You want to market them at scale. You want to be able to put them out there, and not just market them, but also commercialize it. And this is why we're also setting out to provide an application store for these apps being developed on this platform. And last but not least, we need to make sure that integrators, system builders, service providers have the right tool sets to actually integrate then these apps into existing installations or set out to build new things on that. Now, let me take you guys back to the hackathon briefly. The one challenge that a team picked was that one of the security guards complained and says, hey, I have this area where visitors are not allowed to take photos with their flash enabled. Yeah? So over a long-term period, that's not good for the pictures. So that takes a lot of attention to make sure, even if it says, please don't use flash here, that people don't do it. And for us, it was great, really, again, to get these learnings. If you talk to a pure Android developer or other IoT platform developer, and they look at what you built there, you get a lot of good feedback and a lot of good capturing. At the same time, we were really, really, really positively surprised. We were super excited because all these teams we matched up here, they all came back after just 2 days with a working solution. Those two guys here that are shown there came back then really with an app that was able to successfully detect if somebody took a picture with their smartphone with flash enabled and sent a message to the closest security guard close by. And again, for us, the important part and the surprisingly positive part as well was two guys didn't know nothing outside the industry 2 days. Now just imagine, you guys are within the industry. You have so much market knowledge. You know user needs, you know problems, you know untrapped values, you know user needs and customer needs and requests that aren't resolved. What could you build on that? Doesn't matter if you're an integrator, doesn't matter if you're a developer, or whatever role you have to bring this industry forward. If you look at these verticals, for example, in transportation, airports, retail, you know these customer problems. You've seen a problem over the last year where you probably thought, there is some data out there, there is some sand here, I could use it, I don't have the tools right now. I don't have the mechanism available to solve that customer problem in a timely fashion. And in order to get this out of concept stage and really make sure we drive this forward very customer-driven as well, we're going to drive pilots. So we're going to make sure that we go from one vertical to another, drive pilots in these verticals, and you're very much invited to participate there. So if you have an interest or forward-thinking, want to be participating in this, please approach us. Very happy to drive forces there together. Now, yesterday, I was asked a lot, especially from people who knew about us already, who knew me before, hey, Nico, what's next? IC West is next for us. IC West for us is definitely a great moment, a great event for the company, because here is where we're going to bring everything together. We're going to bring app developers from within the industry together with cameras from first manufacturers, pilot cameras, all running on our platform, all supporting our operating system already. We want to showcase this live at the trade show and make sure that it's very publicly out there and open of how much we achieved so far. We're very excited about that. At the same time, because this hackathon was so much fun, we're just going to do it again. So there will be a first live hackathon at ISC, where we're going to invite again developers from outside the industry, Android developers, smartphone developers, computer vision guys, this time from the US. And we're really, really curious and excited this time again what the outcome will be again after just 2 days from people from outside the industry. Thank you so much. See you all at ISC West.